باب المدينة وحامي نبينا باب المدينة وحامي نبينا علي منهج علي تلهج باسمك املاك السماء علي صالة وعلي جالة علي بتار ودماء علي سجدة على خدة للعلي دمعهما علي غيرة وعلي غيرة من كفول فاطمة
Well, I am thrilled that you've chosen Dearborn for the Universal Muslim Association of America to have this wonderful conference. I've looked over the materials, and I think that you're going to find that a lot of the goals and ambitions that you have on a larger scale have already begun to take place in Dearborn, so you'll have some great examples to look at and examine. And I want to thank Dr. Ete Shum Albide, and I want to thank Dr. Parvez Shah for their involvement in bringing this to Dearborn and their engagement. And of course, locally, Saeed Bakr Kushmiri, who also, again, is well known locally and has participated in bringing this to Dearborn. When I said about Dearborn and how it lines up with your goals, I mean, one is civic engagement. Okay, and today, Hussein Berry, we know his sign is here, and he has been an elected representative to our Dearborn School Board. So he plays a leadership role in our school board. Councilwoman Suzanne Serini, another Muslim, has served for 24 years on our Dearborn City Council as elected official. Recently, Judge Sam Salome has been elected our circuit court judge, actually defeating an incumbent. So in this community, there is civic engagement, which I know is one of your missions and one of your goals. And civic engagement results in having people who are representing your interests, who really understand your interests because they're from that community. And that's been achieved for some time in Dearborn, and we're proud of that. But this whole area, I mean, one of the things about coming here that you're going to find, that you won't find many other places is, I mean, the first mosque in the Detroit area was built in the 1920s. And so the idea of mosques in this community and in our broader community has been something that has been familiar and that people are aware of and are not intimidated by, as we see in other places. So that civic engagement is very important. And then the idea of serving the community by bringing in social institutions, education institutions, giving people who come here from other places or who need assistance, is also well rooted in Dearborn. Access, which does exactly that, they work for economic, social justice, they try and make sure that there is an opportunity for everyone, but particularly when they started in 1971 in Dearborn. So that's when they started in Dearborn. They offered all kinds of services to people, to Muslims who were coming here who needed, beyond the faith opportunity, they needed opportunities in employment, in language, in dealing with issues, and some of the issues that you're going to talk about, social and health issues. And so we've had that. And then actually a few years later, ACC, Arab Chaldean Council, formed. So we have grassroots organizations that have been serving Muslims for decades. And again, you'll see, and you can learn from their knowledge and from their experience how to begin to develop similar models in other places. So again, a lot of the things that you're interested in is mirrored here. And also the image things. I mean, because of the success of our community in terms of bridging gaps and being involved in inclusion, it sometimes comes back at us in some ways, and I'm going to give an example. In Dearborn, we have a very strong group called the Dearborn Area Ministerial Association. And Imam Kuzwini is actually an active member of that group, along with other sheikhs, and we have a group, but it's all faiths. It is a group of all faiths that meet monthly, and they talk about how we embrace everyone, how we make sure we have inclusion. They have events that occur to introduce people of different faiths to the elements of the other faiths so that there's understanding, so that we can help people understand how we actually have much more in common than we are different. So they're really agents of understanding, tolerance, and particularly peace. And they have been instrumental in our community when people from outside have attacked us and tried to use Dearborn not as an example of peace and tolerance, but as a way to scare people all around the country and to get them what they do is they're agents of hate, and they try and they tell lies, and they try and misrepresent Islam. They try and misrepresent a lot of things, and of course, in doing that, they misrepresent Dearborn. They make these statements to scare people, saying that Dearborn is under Sharia law. They have no idea what Sharia law is, but they just say it because it sounds scary to people. And we have to confront that. They come here, and we have a festival that's been going on for 18 years. Actually, it started even earlier in another part of Dearborn. This Arab festival, and it's a whole festival, three-day festival, devoted to, you know, Arab culture, music, all kinds of things. Again, so that people become familiar. You never, you know, you hate or fear the things you don't understand. So understanding is an important platform for getting rid of those things and getting people to engage, be tolerant, and accepting. And so, you know, that's part of our community. So again, as I say, as you come here, you're going to see that we've been in place for a long time. The first mosque in South Dearborn was in the 1930s, and both of those two mosques I talked about, the first ones in our area, were actually there because they served people who came from overseas to work for the auto industry. The auto industry in this community, and that's one of the things that I hope you'll get a sense of while you're here, the auto industry drew people from all over the world and all over our country. My own grandfather came from a farm in the far west of the U.S. to come to work for Henry Ford in Dearborn. That's how my family came here, and I've spent my whole life here, because he was offering $5 a day when the average wage was $2 a day. And that certainly was an attractive thing in those days. And you can learn a lot about this, and I'll talk about that in a minute. But the interesting thing is Henry Ford hired everybody. I mean, he was hiring blacks during that period in the 20s when African Americans were really not welcome in a lot of places. He was hiring Muslims in that same time. So there was a universality. There was an opportunity for people to blend, understand each other, begin to understand, you know, that we're, as I say, much more alike in every way than we are different. And so we have opportunities for you to understand what you're trying to do, not only nationally, but globally. There's examples of that here because it's rooted deeper. We've been at it longer. And I think that I'm hopeful that as you go through your conference, you'll have opportunities to look at those models and say, well, what's working? They've been developed over time. But in our community, we have a great acceptance, tolerance, and there's a full integration of everybody. And that's why I say it. Sometimes it scares people. Sharon Angle was running for U.S. Senate in Nevada, and she mentioned Dearborn as especially, of course, Islam is one of those faiths we embrace. We all accept our religious leaders in this community come together and embrace all faiths. We are blessed as a community. And so we become a target from outside. We live with that. But I'm so glad you're here because I want you to see who we are and what goes on in Dearborn. And if you visit Warren Avenue and you go down and shop on our Warren Avenue, you will not want to go home, because you're going to say, I got to be here. I've got, you know, all the markets and shops I could ever want right here. And it's a wonderful place. And I know you have a very busy, aggressive schedule and agenda, but I really hope you have some time to spend here. In addition to that, we have the Henry Ford, which is the Greenfield Village Henry Ford Museum. Built by Henry Ford in the 1920s, it could never be replicated anywhere in the world. What you will see there was done in the 20s at no, sparing no cost. It could not be replicated. And this weekend, there are a couple of major events going on there. One of the major events is that they're having this old car show and stuff. And this place takes you back in time. And what Henry Ford tried to do with this is actually capture the entire American Industrial Revolution in one facility. It is It is entertaining, engaging, but it's also a great educational experience. So again, I know you have a busy agenda. I hope you can go there. And then this Monday is another thing that I just want you to make aware of. We in Dearborn, for 89 years, we have had our Memorial Day Parade. It is one of the largest in the country. It's the largest in Michigan. It is a recognition of everybody who gave an ultimate sacrifice. But for here, one of the groups that marches, of course all our kids march here, all that, but one of the groups that marches are the Arab American veterans who served our country, served as every other person does that's called when the time is there. And they have a group that marches. So again, it shows that Muslims are there visibly as a part of our community and also as a part of our history of people who came in times of conflict and made the ultimate sacrifice to defend our nation. So, and we celebrate that. So as I said, this is a community that includes and it just becomes transparent because we have 5-6 generations of Muslims who've lived right here in our community. So it, you know, they're so intertwined. I mean, Sine, or Mr. Barry, always called Sine, but he and I first met when we were working on children's programs for our children. We were trying to create a new sports program, and we met in my neighbor's house. Mohammed Beydoun. We met at his house, and we started putting together a program for children. And it had nothing to do with what faith anybody was or anything else. It was that the children needed an opportunity, and we came together, we created it, and it became incredibly successful. And that's what I think we're talking about. I mean, one, obviously you have as your mission to make sure that people from the Middle East, from overseas, when they come here, they have opportunities, they have places to go, they have resources. The other one is to fully integrate so that we become one. We're all on the same page and all sharing the same goals. So I really applaud you for what you're doing here this weekend. And I'm so proud and so glad that you came to Dearborn. And if you have any problems, you get a hold of me. And I'll make sure we sort them out. But again, I just think it's great. And I hope you take every opportunity you can here. Thank you very much.